Tonight, a remarkable period in Australian comedy. Never before has there been so much on Australian television. And never before have so many millions of Australians laughed so much at their own culture. Maybe it's because we've become more confident. We don't feel the need to take ourselves so seriously. Or maybe it's because we've become more cynical with the Australian ethos. Whatever the case, there's never been a period like it. Isn't that right, Uncle Arthur?
That's right, young Braddy. A funny thing happened to Australian comedy. It really did.
If there's one character who helps explain the current comedy boom, it's the owner of this car and the magnificent singing voice. Like Con Dicker Lettuce.
Waiting, waiting, waiting.
Kylie Mole.
Doubly spewing.
And Colin Carpenter.
Just one small Hawaiian, thanks.
Uncle Arthur has become part of our national identity.
And I'm looking around and saying, isn't it marvellous up here on Mount Buller? And I'm saying hello, and look at the view down there. Isn't that marvellous? And whoa, I just wanted to get a very special view, didn't I?
His interminable home movies have a timeless quality, something that reaches back to Australia in the 20s and the innocence of vaudeville.
And I hopped off there, and I'll show you how to do some very special skank. And then I went, one, two, three, there.
And all sorts of people find it funny.
You like the stunts?
Yeah, I was going to talk about the stunts. Some people don't really believe you've done the stunts.
Oh, I have. I'll tell you what, I've got Auntie Dawn hanging from things. Auntie Dawn is a stunt double. She's pulled her groin several times doing all that sort of stuff. I want to tell you that much. She's gone through hell for you, and I think you should be a little bit more respectful of her.
While Uncle Arthur's popularity is in itself quite remarkable, what's even more remarkable is the amount of comedy being made in Melbourne at exactly the same time.
Hogan! You know you're not supposed to be in this office unless it's going to get a really big laugh at the expense of us bumbling Germans!
At Channel 7, Fast Forward are making another of the brilliant television parodies which have helped them join the comedy company as one of the highest rating shows on television. However, comedy, like life, was never meant to be easy.
Don't complain with someone doesn't come on.
Can we all just settle down? Sorry, everyone. Sorry it's happened.
Sorry, it's just one big happy family.
Shut up!
You're a passenger in this show, Bartha.
I'm carrying you.
Oh.
Don't you start with
lucky,
me.
Carry her? You've got to be kidding.
At the ABC, Wendy Harmer is waiting to go on live before a national audience on the big gig.
This is live television, folks. This is sick. Audience, and I can sort of vaguely feel folk around me getting slightly nervous. I love doing my audience bit. Do you like my audience bit?
It's fantastic.
The show transfers Melbourne's diverse live cabaret circuit to television. On the one hand, there's the Monty Python violence of the Lager Boys.
G'day! It's a man's world.
And it smells like one too.
Now this smelly man.
When a man's man wants to be a man around other men, many men choose to be a smelly man man.
It's a new sensation for the way today's man will smell tomorrow.
And just as ludicrous, but a little more subtle, are the news breaks hosted by Gene Kitson.
Here's a news update.
Australian airline pilots presented the government with a new log of claims today. They include a moustache allowance, hereditary knighthoods, and a demand that all airline pilots be saluted in the streets by civilians below the rank of 200,000 per year.
The ABC lampooning the ABC News. Once unthinkable, now almost inevitable. For the last 10 years, the stars of television have been the stars of news and current affairs.
And I'm Richard Carlton.
I'm Richard Carlton.
Thank you, Graham, John.
Thanks, Graham. Thanks, John. George.
Now the comedians are looming as fearsome competitors.
As a Labor backbencher convinced battling homeowners that the Hawke government is on the right track, and
is this the end of the road for Mr. Hawke or merely a rest stop on the highway of journalistic cliché?
Now it's hard to tell the difference between the comic...
Why not? That's what happens to defenceless premature babies...
...and the commentator.
But it doesn't end there.
For comedians such as Barry Humphries, the heroes of current affairs are like free targets in a public shooting gallery.
Heroes? Well, Darren Hinch is a famous television personality and journalist whose face, or what we can see of it, is very well known. Perfect subject for comedy.
Forgive me, Father, for I have sinned.
If comedy is a new religion, then television is the evangelical pulpit.
Coming up soon, the story of a pederast who performed hair transplants on young children. But first...
And few things are funnier than television itself, especially when it doesn't intend to be.
Shame, boys, and shame!
After the break, the comedians crucify television.
I'm Richard Carlton. Take a six-pack of journalists, buy an atlas, add a little alliteration, end every sentence with a question, and you'd think you'd have a top-rating Sunday night, 7:30, current affairs show.
If ever there was easy game in the satire shooting gallery, it's the native Australian television personality. And needless to say, they relish the attention.
It's wonderful. I'm all in favour. It's tremendous. I mean, it's not necessarily original. I mean, it's as hard to be original in comedy, I think, as it is in current affairs.
How's that? You missed a bad, I caught you out, how's that?
Mark Mitchell in Gibbo mode. If you listen to the original, this sort of thing is actually good for your health.
Well, I didn't realise I was so fat. I mean, that's why I lost a bit of weight as soon as I saw Mark Mitchell do that. So I got to pull off some kilos. But no, seriously, I loved it. I mean, I like to send people up, and therefore, if you do that, you have to be prepared to be sent up too. And I think Mark does a wonderful giver.
You see, I'm centering myself as all great actors did, Larry. It's an important thing to do. I center myself, and then I learn the lines.
International lawyer turned comedy writer turned executive producer. He's the driving force behind Fast Forward, and perhaps its most wicked satirist.
We could just bring this whole country to its knees. The meaning of life is all very well, but won't help you when you're confronted by a plane load of drunken footballers doing disgusting things with complimentary headphones.
On most days of the week at Channel 7, you'll find Vizard being glued, gummed and skull-capped into the shape of other people. Sometimes he's the multi-millionaire television personality Bill Cosby.
I'm going to ask you a question, and I'm only going to ask the question once. Who tarred and feathered Grandpa Hoxtable?
Sometimes he's a gangling Peter Garrett. He doesn't so much slip into character as slam into it head first.
Humpty Dumpty sat on a wall. Fair enough. As long as he wasn't trespassing, it's free country. However, Humpty Dumpty had a great fall. We had to ask, was Humpty Dumpty out of his mind on drugs?
And the character he slips into with most relish is the extraordinary Darren Hinch.
That somebody can be so sincere on so many issues, so regularly, like every night, is just beyond belief. I mean, I don't know how you could sleep. Imagine going home and just thinking to yourself, you know, shame, just being so sincere all the time, you know. Imagine if you broke a piece of crockery in the house. Shame, Jackie, shame.
Shame, Vizard, shame.
Shame, 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 Darren. This is the real one. This is the real McCoy.
How do you react when Darren Hinch comes on?
It's a bit unnerving the first
time you see or you see your mannerisms, you know, exaggerated. I suppose like slightly. It's like some of the. And of course now, as the time goes by, he has to get worse, right? Yeah. Has to go further and further over the top.
Later in the show, I'll be exposing some more of these anarchistic, irresponsible propaganda that's disguised as the so-called nursery rhymes. You owe to your children, your children's children, your children's children's children to be watching. I don't hunch, and I'm sticking my thumb into pies and pulling out plums, and what a good boy am I.
If the Hinch parody is close to the bone, then what happened to Channel 9's George Denikian was even closer.
Bear with me while I go through the motions that a powerful sexual animal such as myself must necessarily go through.
When George shaved off his moustache, that was terrific stuff, because it occurred to me that he didn't leave himself anywhere to go.
George Denikian, Socceroo skipper Charlie Yankos and defender Mihamed Dorovi have been recruited to South Melbourne. Kero Chavkovic, who led forfeit promotions in the Victorian League, will replace John Colignelli. In tennis today, Ivan Lendl defeated Michael Chang.
I enjoyed it. I think that's what it was. Because it was, for me, it was a case of, you have finally arrived. And Graham Kennedy said the same thing. He pulled me aside and said, you know, that's an awfully big pat on the back. Mm. You know, because they only pick a few people.
The secret of making successful television comedy is simple. Take a small group of highly intelligent people and work 14 hours a day, 6 days a week, under incredible pressure.
Maybe it's dog eat dog out there on telly.
Oh, dog eat dog for you maybe, but I'm cooperating, I'm pulling my weight. I'm not just a passenger like some of us.
Leave no time for a second take, and above all, always be funny all the time.
Something top secret of the utmost confidentiality to the Third Reich!